The metals are malleable, ductile. Almost all metals are solid in nature, except mercury. Being a metal, it is liquid at room temperature. So some of few physical properties we discussed, and metals are good conductors of heat as well as electricity. That is what, for heat we use the word thermal conductivity, and for electricity, electrical conductivity. So that thermal conductivity is also good in metals. Good thermal conductors are the metal, as well as electrical conductivity is also good in the metals. So next point, that is melting point, next physical property of metals. We are discussing physical properties of metals. In that we discussed the physical state and their appearance, malleability, ductility and lustreness, as well as thermal conductivity and electrical conductivity. And now we will discuss melting point. Melting point of metals. Melting point of metals. So here the melting point, usually it is very high in a metallic compounds. Melting point is very high. So almost all metals have high melting point. Right? So write down here, metals have high melting point. Metals generally have high melting point. Right? Almost all metals have high melting point. Example we can consider, if you consider the example, that is tungsten. Tungsten has almost 3400 degree Celsius. It is of about 3422. Nearly we are going to put accurate is 3422 degree Celsius. Tungsten, melting point of tungsten is 3422 degree Celsius. That's the reason we are using tungsten in a bulb, so that even though it heats more, it will not melt soon. That's the reason the tungsten wire we are using in a bulb. Okay, then, but some exceptions also there, exception metals are there where their melting point is not high, their melting point is low. What are those exceptions? Lithium, sodium and potassium. Lithium, sodium and potassium have low melting point. Okay, these have low melting points. Low melting points. Okay, these are some exception, right? And even cesium, gallium also. Those are usually we used to say that radioactive compounds, cesium and gallium. Those also have low melting point. So the next physical property of the metal is melting point. Almost all the generally melting point of the metals is very high. Example we can consider the tungsten, and here the except lithium, sodium and potassium, their melting point is low. Then after this melting point, the another property is sonority, right? The another melting point, when we have seen some of the metals we are using for the to produce some sounds, we are producing some sonor, right? That property we use to say that sonority, right? Some metals produce when they are beaten, right? Sonority. It is a property at which some metals produces the sound. Okay, it is the property of. It is a property of producing sound on striking. Producing striking. A hard surface. That's the reason why some metals are using for a sound purpose, like violin and sitar, right? So where these metals are? Metals are sonorous. Okay, the sonority means what? The property of that metal which produces sound when they start on striking on a hard surface. Okay, that is what. And here it means these metals are sonorous. Such type of metals, what we used to say that sonorous. The metals which produces sound when they are striking into the hard surface. Okay, those are called sonorous. Those metals what we used to call sonorous metals, and that property is known as sonority, right? And here, then where these metals are used for making bells, these metals are used. Where we are using, we have seen that for bell making are used for making bells, right? In temples you would have seen that, right? And even in home also you can see that small bells, right? And the string of musical instrument, almost all the strings of musical instruments, right? We've seen that almost all musical instruments like guitar and violin. Okay, the strings of those musical instruments are made up of the such type of metals where they are sonorous. Where when they are going to strike with a hard surface, they are going to produce some sound. So that property we used to say that sonority, and such type of metals are known as sonorous metals. And then another property is density. Another physical property is density. What is this density? How we are going to define density? Density is what? Mass per volume, right? We are going to say that density is what? Mass per volume. And the unit of measuring density is what? SI unit is meter per cubic centimeter. Okay? Gram per cubic centimeter. Or in SI unit we used to say that kg per cubic meter. So here, how we can say that the metals, whether metals have high density or low density? Yes, because we know that the atoms, they are closely bound, binding one another. So here, they have high density. Metals have high density. Okay, almost all, because atoms are closely packed. Because atoms are closely Okay, the next property is, next property of the metal is, and same thing here, those exceptions are the except again lithium, sodium and potassium. These are very soft metal, right? These are soft metals, that's the reason they have low density. They have low density. Low density. Except, I told you in metal, some exceptions. When we were discussing, there are the states of some matter. At room temperature, almost all metals are solid in state except mercury, right? And when their hardness, that time also these are soft, and remaining all metals are hard. And even in density, these are have low density, also low melting point. You should remember, right? These are soft but highly reactive element. Next, while when we are discussing chemical properties, that time we will come to know that these are known, these metals, sodium and potassium, these are highly reactive elements. Okay. Next property is tensile strength. Almost all metals have high tensile strength. Okay. They have the how much you can put a load bearing capacity before they break. Okay. They have more capacity to hold the more load. That is what? Tensile strength. Tensile strength is more in metals. It is like a metals have high tensile strength. Metals have high tensile strength. Okay, you can say that load bearing capacity before they break. Okay, till then, before they break, they can hold the capacity of the load. Okay, yes. These are physical properties of metal. So, what all properties we discussed? Almost all metals are solid in state at room temperature except mercury, and metals are hard. Okay, except sodium, lithium and potassium. And metal shows the lustrous property. Then metals also shows the property of malleability and ductility. Malleability means even though those metals are beaten with a hammer, they can be prepared with a thin sheets, and if they undergo, they can also prepare in the form of wire, right? So for the example for malleability, aluminum foil, silver foil, gold foils, right? And for the ductility, copper wire for the communication purpose, we had seen that copper wire is the transformation of energy, right? And aluminium steel wire. Like that, the malleability as well as ductility and the melting point and boiling point of metals are high. Density of the metals is also high, except lithium, sodium, and potassium. And tensile strength of metals is also high. So these are the physical properties of metals. Now we'll discuss physical properties of non-metals. So what are these non-metals? The metals which doesn't show any lustrous and are not good conductor of electricity as well as heat, those are known as non-metals. Non-metals. Physical properties of non-metals. So, how we are going to define non-metals? It is like, how we are going to define metals which do not possess luster. Non-metals, they do not possess luster, do not conduct heat or electricity, right? And they do not possess neither malleable nor ductile. Brittle. Okay. This is what we used to say that non-metals. Another way also we are going to define non-metals with the help of gaining electrons. Then whether non-metals gain electrons to form negative ions. The elements, again this it can be defined as the elements from the elements form negative ion by gaining electrons. Negative ions by gaining electron. So here this is the one of the property where we can distinguish the elements as non-metals. What is that? The elements which forms negative ions by gaining electrons. So what are the elements? They are going to be negative ions by gaining electron from the another element. Those metals are known as non-metals. So here the metals which do not possess any luster, they do not conduct heat or electricity, and neither malleable nor ductile, but they are brittle. And also if they form negative ion by gaining electron, such elements are known as non-metals. Then what are the physical properties of these non-metals? We discuss one by one. And here the first property we are going to discuss, that is physical state. Physical state of that non-metal. What will be that physical state of non-metals? Either solid, liquid or gas. Yes? So here physical state of non-metals. At room temperature, non-metal can exist. The first property, physical state. Right? Physical state. At room temperature, non-metals can exist in all the three physical states. Remember that. At room temperature, non-metals can exist in all the three states. What are those all the three states? Solid, liquid and gas. Right? Okay. Then, so here the here carbon, okay, phosphorus and sulfur, carbon, phosphorus, sulfur, okay, and iodine are solid. Okay. Then next examples for liquid, which is liquid at room temperature, non-metal, that is bromine. We have heard that bromine water, that it is in liquid state. At room temperature, non-metals at room temperature, bromine is in liquid state. And the non-metals which are in gaseous state, hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, chlorine. Hydrogen, nitrogen, oxygen, chlorine are gaseous state. Gases. So here the physical state of non-metals can exist at room temperature. Almost all non-metals can exist in three states: solid, liquid, and gaseous. Okay, this is the first physical property of non-metal. Then second property is appearance. Second property is what? Appearance. How these non-metals are. Okay. The second property of non-metal is appearance. So here non-metals are generally non-lustrous. Appearance. Almost all non-metals are non-lustrous. Okay, almost all non-metals are non-lustrous. But there is also one exception is there, that is iodine. Okay, iodine is a lustrous non-metal. Exception, iodine is a lustrous non-metal. Iodine is a lustrous non-metal. Right? Then next property. Non-metals do not possess any malleability or ductility. Right? You can write down here this property. Non-metals are neither malleable nor ductile. Non-metals are neither malleable nor ductile. Then next, brittleness. So almost all non-metals are brittle in nature. They break into pieces when hammered. So here, brittleness. Almost all non-metals are brittle because when they are hammered, when they hammer, they can break into small pieces. So non-metals are brittle in nature. Non-metals are brittle in nature. So brittle in nature means what? When hammered, they can break down into small pieces. They can break into small pieces. They can break into small pieces. sorry, they can break into small pieces, right? Then hardness, non-metals are soft. Next property is hardness. Non-metals are soft in nature. Non-metals are soft in nature. Okay, but you know that some non-metals are there, not some, specially diamond being a carbon allotrope. Okay, diamond is a non-metal, but it is a allotrope of carbon. So therefore, here diamond is hard. Okay, except diamond. Exception is what? Diamond. Okay, is this what? Hard. Diamond is what? Hard. Okay. Hardest substance. Diamond is a hardest substance. Right? Then next property is electrical and thermal conductivity. We know that on non-metals do not possess any thermal conductivity or electrical conductivity, but one exception is there. What is that exception? Graphite, right? We know that graphite we are using for to making electrodes. So it seems that graphite possesses electric conductivity. So here graphite also an allotrope of carbon. Okay, I think you know that the meaning of allotropy. Allotropy is what? It is a property of a substance where they are going to occur in a different form, but those different form of that element have the same chemical properties, but they're different in their structure. Okay, that is what we used to say that allotropes. So we know that diamond and graphite are the allotropes of carbon. Okay, right? Then try now here. Next is electrical and thermal conductivity. Electrical and thermal conductivity. So here non-metals do not conduct electricity or heat. Okay, whereas graphite is non-metals. Non-metals do not conduct heat or electricity, right? But exception is what? Graphite. It is a allotrope of carbon. An allotrope of carbon. So if graphite is what? It is a good conductor of electricity. Okay, whereas this graphite is using to make electrodes. Okay, electrodes are going to be made by using graphite. For example, you can do that. Take a pencil, okay, and sharpen the tip of that pencil. Just take a connecting wire, connected one end. Pencil sharpen both ends, connected, and you can just small LED. If you connect it, a small one to it, you will come to know that graphite conduct electricity. Simple experiment, you can do it. Take a pencil, sharpen both ends, connect two wires, because we need one should be positive terminal and a negative terminal, and connect a small bulb, the bulb will glow. So here it indicates graphite being a non-metal, it conducts electricity, The reason behind that, it is an allotrope of carbon. Also, the graphite, there is a free electron cell there. That's the reason it possesses conductivity. Yes? Okay. Then, melting point. Almost all non-metals have low melting point, except diamond and graphite has high melting point. Okay? Melting point of non-metals. Melting point. Non-metals have low melting point, except diamond and graphite, where diamond and graphite have high melting point. Okay, then remaining even sonority, non-metals, non-sonorous, and density also. The non-metal density is also lighter than compared to metals, and tensile strength. The non-metal tensile strength is also less. So here we discuss the physical properties of metals as well as non-metals. Whereas in the next class we are going to discuss chemical properties of non-metals, metals and non-metals.